Quantower Algo. Strategy Debugging in Visual Studio 2022. In the previous video, we demonstrated how to get started with coding for Quantower using Visual Studio Community 2022 and Quantower Algo extension. Today, we will focus on efficiently debugging and modifying your strategy on the go. In order to begin debugging, it is necessary to have both a running Quantower terminal and an open strategy project in Visual Studio. Prior to starting, debugging must be configured by accessing the Quantower Algo settings in the Studio Options menu and navigating to the Algo tab within the Quantower Terminal General Settings screen. To connect Visual Studio with Quantower Algo, we need to enable the Allow Connection from Visual Studio option in the Terminal Settings and ensure that the connection port matches the one in the Quantower Algo settings. Great, it appears that we're prepared to begin debugging our code. First, press the Debug Mode Launch button and wait for Visual Studio to establish the debugging environment. One of the critical elements of this environment is a specialized console process that connects your code editor and Quantower terminal. In case you haven't opened the Backtest and Optimize panel yet, Quantower will remind you to do so and select your strategy. Next, you'll need to configure the backtesting environment and locate the Start and Debug Mode button at the bottom of the sidebar. Click on this button to begin debugging your strategy. To better understand what's happening, let's arrange the debug environment components side by side. After that, locate the specific line in your Visual Studio editor, where the algorithm needs to be paused, and set a breakpoint there. We have noticed that the strategy backtest has come to a halt. We can now conveniently examine the variable's value, make any necessary changes to the code, and perform other tasks related to debugging. For example, we can go through our algorithm step by step to verify its logic and ensure that all necessary actions are carried out. As an illustration, we can comment out one of our metrics and then click the Continue button. This will result in the metric disappearing from the Backtest and Optimize panel. It's important to remember that we can modify our code at any time while Studio is paused on one of the breakpoints. To exit debug mode, simply click on the Stop button, a red square icon located to the right of the Continue button on the Visual Studio Debug toolbar. This will close the binding console process and disconnect Visual Studio from the Quantower terminal. Now it's your time to create your code for Quantower and find out how it works using the well-known and straightforward debug mode. Have good coding!